fraternity at the University of Virginia says it plans to sue Rolling Stone magazine over what it calls reckless reporting on a rape story. CBS 2's Dick Brennan reports the magazine retracted the article that's now the subject of a blistering review by the Columbia Journalism School.
The report from the Columbia Graduate School of Journalism was requested by Rolling Stone, and it was a scathing review, saying the magazine did not follow the basics when telling the story about a supposed brutal campus rape.
It was the collective fault of the reporter, the editor, the editor's supervisor, and the fact-checking department.
In the article published last November, a woman identified as Jackie described a gang rape by seven men at the University of Virginia's Phi Kappa Psi fraternity in 2012. But the Columbia report says the writer never contacted Jackie's accused attackers or her friends who say they were with her that night, including Alex Stock and Ryan Duffin.
I think that that was pretty clear in the Rolling Stone piece that, you know, it was almost too perfect of a story.
And what the two remember is very different from what Jackie told Rolling Stone.
No, I didn't notice any sort of physical injuries. I didn't really notice anything.
Rolling Stone initially pointed the finger at Jackie for misleading the reporter, but Columbia says the real problem was bad journalism.
It was, as we pointed out in the report, questions of putting the burden of the entire story almost entirely on a single source.
Now, women's advocates say this case shouldn't change how rape victims get treated.
One bad story, one bad situation does not represent in any way, shape, or form the thousands upon thousands of sexual assaults that happen.
Now, police in Virginia say they found no evidence of a crime. The writer, Sabrina Rubin Eardley, says, and Rolling Stone editors have apologized, but the magazine says both will keep their jobs. Maurice.
Okay, Dick, thank you.